climate change deniers always love to point to Koch brothers funded research indicating that climate change doesn't exist. But what if you look at real peer-reviewed studies that are published in scientific journals? How many of those studies indicate that climate change is just a hoax? Well, there's a gentleman by the name of James Lawrence Powell. He's with the National Science Board, and he looked at 13,950 peer-reviewed climate articles between 1991 and 2012. Only 24 of them reject global warming, or to be specific, 0.17% of them.
So, you know, I used to say 98% of the world's scientists agree that global warming is real and man-made. It turns out it's actually a little over 99.8% of at least the scientific studies. Mm-hmm. That's amazing. And yet, on TV, you hear nearly 50-50. You know, get this Senator Inhofe's coming on there. And by the way, then you've got the Republicans who are now running the Science and Technology Committee. Literally, those same exact congressmen saying the media is too unbalanced on this and should give more weight to the people who don't believe in global
warming.
That's
unbelievable to me, especially when you look at the scientific evidence. And also, you know, after the floods in New York, you would assume that it would really raise awareness. Okay, Hurricane Sandy, you know, all of this extreme weather, let's have a real discussion about climate change. Well, only 69% of New Yorkers believe that Hurricane Sandy was in part caused by, or the extreme weather was caused by climate change, which amazes me. I mean, 69% is supposed to be a high number, but really, what about the rest? I mean, why do you think this is happening to New York?
Why do you think it's happening all over the country? Why do you think we're breaking record after record? We've gone over 300 months where we were higher temperature than the global
normal
average from before. I mean, you can go on. July.
What year is it? If you were born like after 1988, you've never experienced a month that is cooler than average?
No, I think it was earlier than that, 1980 or something like that. Mm-hmm. You've never experienced a month that was cooler than the global average. It's amazing. You know, July was the hottest month on record in history.
Can you put up that graphic one more time again, the little pie chart? So that's in 21 years, there have been 24 rejected. So what those Republicans who lead the panel now would say is that every year there's like one or two studies a year that says it, every single year, that denies climate change.
On average.
And yet the media continues to suggest that this is an open and shut case.
And that chart also tells me one other thing. And so Anna asked why, right? Well, nobody could look at that chart. Nobody can look at these scientific studies and have a legitimate debate about it. I mean, it's almost, I don't want to use inflammatory analogies, but it's a preposterous debate, right? It is not a debate. So why does it happen? Of course it happens because of money and politics, because the oil companies get nearly $14 billion a year in subsidies, and they don't want regulation, and they want subsidies, and they want all these different things, and they hate the EPA because it would add cost, they say, to what they do, et cetera, right? So we all know that. So they're actually winning. We're not doing anything about it. Cap and trade was defeated in Congress. We hardly agree to anything during the different environmental get-togethers, Kyoto, Copenhagen, et cetera. And so to me, when I see that chart, put it up one more time, it's a perfect example of money in politics. That tiny little slice of red is winning. Now, do you think it's because of facts? Do you think it's because of democracy? Do you think it's because of our votes? Or do you think that slice of red is winning because they've got more money? Everybody knows the answer to that. So who are we kidding? We don't have a democracy. Our government's run by whoever's got more money.